Hey guys, what's happening? We are at the Sturbridge Rod and Gun Club on a beautiful Saturday afternoon. The Italian Motorcycle Owners Club event just ended and they're loading up some of the nice bikes. I wanted to show you a couple cool pieces that caught my eye. This is actually, I don't know too much about it, never seen one before, but it says Devil on the Tank, OCMA. Beautiful paint job, nice upholstery on it. This thing was beautifully restored. Sir, can you tell me a little bit about this bike? I've never really seen one of these before.
Sure. I guess we can answer the fellow's questions. Yeah, I think it's a 1954, right, Chris?
1954.
It's an OCMA Devil.
The company in Italy, actually.
Yep.
Como, Italy, they made them between 52 to 57, actually. This is the first year they made this one. It's a Sports Russo. This was like the Rolls Royce, kind of the higher end model. It's a two-stroke 160.
It's beautiful.
We restored it 2 years ago. It took us a year to restore it.
How many, where do you find parts for something like this?
You can't.
You know, see, so you make the parts from scratch? Just
fabricate them. And stuff. Yeah, like the Camaro, we had to fabricate some parts.
It's just stunning. Beautiful piece.
Thank you.
Never seen one before. What are the production stats on this? Or is this something that's a...
For the total year, between 52 and 57,
yeah.
Yours, they might made maybe 20,000, maybe.
You're pretty young. You're a pretty young guy. Where'd you get all this knowledge at this age to?
I research them.
You research them? How old are you?
26.
Oh, it's awesome to see younger guys getting into the antique motorcycle thing. You know, my son's 20. He's big time into it too. And we just sold an Indian Chief to a guy who's 31 years old. We all know New England Motorcycle Museum in Rockville, Connecticut.
Okay.
So,
of this model, there's a guy in California who has a 55 two-stroke 160, but that's a super sport.
So this is the only one in the world?
This is the only one Sports Lusso model.
Wow.
So the Ferrari.
So the production stats are really low.
Yeah, that Ferrari, that's only one of two.
There's a Ferrari motorcycle in here? You mind if I take a video of it? We'd love to have you bring these to the museum sometime. Have you been there yet?
No, I know you. I seen you on YouTube, actually.
This is stunning. Is this a Ferrari motorcycle?
This is a Fratelli Ferrari motorcycle. This is one of two.
Wow. Look at that.
Cafe Racer. It's not involved with Enzo Ferrari.
It's absolutely stunning.
It's all original. Works very well.
Where did you get
Italy.
Something like this?
In Italy.
I look for them when we bring them over. This one is...
Are there a bunch of these in the U.S.? Or
the fellow who sold us this in Italy, he's a broker for bikes, he says he never sold one before.
This one here?
No, the Ferrari.
What's this one here? Is it Aramaki? Yeah, like the Harley-Davidson Aramakis, right?
Well, actually, the other way around. The Harley-Davidson bought Aramaki.
That's true, yes.
And the motor that's in here is the...
Harley-Davidson ruined everything, didn't they?
Yeah. Well, they keep the engine alive, at least. There's a monoshock, first monoshock ever built.
Wow, what type of motor is in this?
It's a 175 horizontal four-stroke.
It looks brand new. The level of fit and finish on your restorations are... This is a 100-point bike, pretty much.
Close to it.
I'm also a judge for the AMCA, so looking at it...
They only gave us a 97.
The bastards.
Yeah.
What did they pick apart on it?
Oh, they found it. See that little bit right there?
Uh-oh.
See that?
Not really. Look at this. There's a scuff on a bolt, and they took a point off.
Yeah, they took a point.
Are you kidding me? That can happen at the factory when they're producing them. You know what I'm saying? I mean,
I think it looks better now than it was in the factory.
It didn't look this good coming out of the factory, I'm sure.
So we had to make like this trim here. We'd have to.
How many bikes have you guys restored?
I think about three or four.
Yeah, Camaro, the M50, and the Devil.
You went right to the top. So let's get a bike that's one of one, no other one on the planet,
yes.
And a Ferrari motorcycle, and you're 26 years old.
That's all it takes.
We
split it 50.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Father, son?
Yep.
Yeah.
Awesome. How old are you?
I'm 59.
59, so we're about the same age, yeah. So.
You look a little more healthy than me, though.
Well, I hit the gym every day, but I have a girlfriend that really takes care of me.
I bet you
all gluten-free and...
I hope
she's yeah. Well, I don't have a wife, so that's okay. So, yeah, the Ferrari motorcycle. What type of engine is it? Two-stroke?
It's a two-stroke 150cc. We also have a four-stroke 250cc, and there's only one of them in the world, and I only seen that on Google Image.
What is it? How do you price a bike like this that there's not, like that one over there, it's the only one on the planet, so
yeah, I mean, it's whatever
you're willing to sell it for.
Yeah, whatever you're willing to pay for it. This one was rather pricey from Italy.
What's a bike like this worth, if you don't mind me asking?
Worth?
Yeah.
Oh, gee. I mean, I know what I paid for it. I'm going to say it's worth anywhere between $30,000 and $40,000, maybe. I don't know.
There was actually in 2017, there was two Fratelli Ferraris, both restored. They're both two-stroke, 165cc.
Yeah.
And they sold for $40,000 each.
Is this a racing model?
It's like, yeah, cafe racer.
Yeah, you can see it's got the bullet nose on it.
We have all the, you know, the headlight assembly and other motors.
Just beautiful, beautiful.
And then a year later in 2018, one of those went back on the auction for $55,000.
Do you guys bring them to shows and ride them also, or are they mostly, are they...
No, we don't ride them mostly, just, you know, around the yard, up and down the trail, that kind of thing.
What's this one out here? You got another one out here.
That's the first one we did.
You fit all four of these in the trailer?
That's
a tight fit, right?
Yeah, it's a Harley option.
This is a cool piece. Yeah, this is not an Aramaki, or it is. It is.
Built in Italy in the Aramaki factory. It's shipped here to the States for the chance of $215 American.
Yeah.
And the only thing they add, rest is all Italian.
Oh,
but
yeah, tail light.
The tail light, it says USA on it, but the inside of it. So if you take
Year is this one?
First year, 65.
The paint job's stunning on it. Who painted it?
We did 6 years ago.
You guys paint it like this?
We do all the painting.
Where'd you learn how to paint like this?
Got brain cancer. You know what? Did you do it until you get it right? If you're patient enough?
So, because these paint jobs.
This one here was three times I had to paint.
So, have you been a painter for a long time, or?
Just a hobby.
Jeez, you know, it's kind of like when you see hobbyists turning out. There's another guy, Ted Smith, the president of the Antique Motorcycle Club of America Yankee chapter. He's a hobbyist, and his BMW restorations are world class. You know, they're 197 to 100 point bikes.
It's all about how much time you want to spend on it.
It's a labor of love, clearly. I mean. The amount of time it takes to get something this. You must have wet sanded and buffed this thing. And
what we actually do, we strips them. I don't do that anymore, but he strips them and we send them out to a friend who vapor blasts.
Oh, no kidding. We just got a vapor blasting cabinet. It's on its way here. I haven't used it yet. You vapor blast the metal too?
All the body parts. The Camaro was completely vapor blast.
The Devil too.
So you vapor blast all the components down even?
We'll strip all the paint.
With the vapor blaster?
By hand.
By hand?
And then we'll bring it to our guy, and then he'll vapor blast it all. It'll look like the day it was made.
That takes the rest of the stuff off?
It's like the day it was made. You get this metal, and it's just gorgeous.
And the stuff you sent out, you have it re-chromed, some of it?
We have them re-chromed. This we actually bought a secondary one. But all the aluminum, mostly, we'll all polish that. Chris does a lot of the polishing.
Just beautiful. How do you polish it? You have a wheel?
We got a...
Yeah. It's a lot of labor. Have you ever tracked the hours you put into one of these?
I probably do almost 75 to 100 hours. At least 400 hours, maybe more.
If you had to pay a shop to do it would be ridiculously expensive. They charge $90 an hour.
The Camaro, I polished that too, and it took a lot longer to polish because the drums are bigger and there's more stuff to polish.
Every level of polishing, you know, you go to the next level, get that mirror-like finish, and get to a point where you just want it to sit enough.
The best part of all this for me is seeing a father-son relationship where you guys are. On a Sunday afternoon, just the two of you, no cell phones, focusing on something you both love, which is a motorcycle. It's a common bond that, you know, you'll have forever. Yeah. And my son and I have that same thing, and I'm blessed with the fact that I get to work with him full-time doing this. And I retired from the computer industry 8 years ago. What's that?
Yeah, you don't look like a computer
guy. Well, I had short hair and I was 250 pounds at the time, but I haven't cut my hair in a while, but... Yeah, I was a suit and tie guy, and
me too.
I retired and just did start doing bikes with my kid, you know, and we love it. We have spent so much time together.
Retired.
And we ride them. We ride the shit out of them every day at the museum.
Really?
Every single day, yeah. We have a lot of fun. Let's come check it out.
We have a couple cars we've been working on, too.
You do cars, too? Cars are great. They just take up so much more room. You can't fit four of them in the back of your trailer.
More money, more time, more aggravation.
Yeah, and it's a lot more space.
Because, you know, just spend the time on the computer, getting all the history about who owns it, where it came from, how old they were, why they got sued, why they had to put it this way.
Where did you originally find this one to start
this
restoration?
We searched most of Italy in one of our brokers in Bersano di Grappa.
So you have connections overseas to source the bikes? How did you figure that out?
Yeah, we got some family over there and just phone calls and internet.
Awesome. People. Excellent.
Talk to enough people, you know, they'll put you in the right place. We haven't hit the Holy Grail yet. We're waiting to go over there and someone take us to some guy's old yard, you know, and open up that barn.
Yeah.
And I'm like, wow.
Mom's gonna be mad. It's a candy store.
What's so, next? What are your goals next with restorations? Obviously, these four are completed. They can't get any better than they are, right? So.
With the motorcycles, I think we're okay for a while. We have a 35 Ford. I'm doing a frame up on. I'm not done with.
Awesome.
And I bought a nice little roadster that I like to drive.
Excellent. So, excellent.
That's fun.
At 26, you've still got a long ways to go. All right. Do you have any? You got a huge list of bikes you want to do?
There's about five bikes right now.
What's your top three?
Top five. Is a 1938 MM250 four-stroke cafe racer. If I can get it here, probably the only one in the world, in America.
Wow.
Another one was a 1937, same thing, four-stroke 250, and that's a CM. And that's, they were, I think, in business for less than 10 years, both of them. A Maserati motorcycle would be cool.
That'd be a cool piece, yeah. Can't say that I've seen every one of those around here.
I had seen one of them here
at the first show
5 years ago when we first came. It was, but the thing about Maserati motorcycles, they made them between like 55, 54 to 1960, but they got more popular in a car, so they shut down a plant and continue making cars. But for Maserati is a 250 four-stroke. It's the only four-stroke 250 they ever made.
Wow.
Between 1958 and 1959.
Very cool.
So what kind of Italian bikes do you have?
We have Ducatis. We have
Museum Fly and the 250.
Well, guys, thank you for your time today,
thank
for
you.
Sharing the, your pride and joys
you
with you.
Come by and check out your place for sure.
Absolutely love to see you guys in the museum.
All right, thanks.
Stay tuned. God bless America.